Welcome to Honest Book Reviews. If you are new to the channel, please subscribe. Today we will be reviewing The Orange is the New Black, My Year in a Women's Prison book by Piper Kerman. With the exception of the title, Piper's character and her backstory, the TV series has added a tremendous amount of story arcs and detail to other prisoners. There was just enough detail about her fellow inmates without it turning into a soap opera. Unlike the dramatic, sometimes frightening encounters in the TV series, Piper's personal experiences revealed far more about the humanity of her fellow inmates and how her interactions with them brought her face to face with her own part in how drugs and the penal system are destroying people and families. Much of the book deals with the daily tedium of prison life, which isn't always page-turning material. Thus Kerman's otherness, her basic likability and adaptability among some tough women who can't wait for a cute blonde like her to disrespect them, is one factor that makes Orange is the New Black most readable. There's a lot less sex, aggression and hostility and more home cooking in the book. Piper doesn't rail against it, but her factual statements help shed so much light on the system. She was blessed to have such a great support system on the outside to help sustain her through her time. She, like Piper, was put into an unreasonable circumstance for a one-time poor decision and was helpful to her fellow inmates as they were to her. Another thing which should be addressed is prison also teaches you how to become a better criminal instead of being reformed in many cases. The characters were well developed and it was nice to have a bit less drama. Piper's story is a real eye-opener and it demonstrates the resiliency of women when put in very difficult situations. This book shines a light into some very dark and not often talked about corners of our world, women's prisons. Kerman has storytelling down to an art and her descriptions and feelings jumped off the page. She truly captures the raw emotion and experience of prison life and sporadically addresses prison reform in a way that doesn't feel like you rereading a persuasive essay. With no stone left unturned, the reader learns what it is like to go to prison and the physical and emotional price one has to pay for crossing a moral and legal boundary. Like zero tolerance programs in schools, it has taken the judgment away from judges ruining lives without slowing or stopping or rehabilitating those drug trade or those whose lives are ruined by drugs. The drug cartels and all the blood on their hands could not exist without the American consumption of their blood-stained products. White people can and do get along with people of other races just fine in and out of prison. A lot of the things Piper described are really how things are in minimum security prisons. But in a minimum security setting, yeah, a white person really could be friends with almost everyone. It looks more like bad editing than bad writing. On that note, there were a couple of sentences that were poorly drafted, but it isn't something a normal person would get stuck on. To be clear, this isn't a story about what it's like to survive in a really severe prison environment, but that's part of what makes this interesting and a little easier to relate to and comprehend. It's not a how to book as to prison survival. It's not a whiny complaining attack the system book. Yes, there is some attack the system in there, but it's exactly correct and appropriate. For the rest of you mature enough to think outside the box, this is worth a read. It is interesting in that you get a look at the culture in a women's federal prison, but since it is a federal prison, it's really not what you might expect. A snobby little rich white girl gets dumped into the federal prison system, which is not that bad compared to county jails. She learned not to look down on others just because they weren't wearing the latest clothes or to criticize those without money or a job. She is an advisor on a women's prison board, but being a convicted felon has lost a lot of her previously held rights. This book is one of support and togetherness and at times leaves the reader shaking his or her head about the minimal effort for ready to release women into society. A great majority in society would be better served if the prison sentencing protocols were based on the impact of the crime and not skin pigmentation. It seemed that her fellow inmates grew to trust her and seek her out for advice and tutoring. So many of the procedures that prison officials implement are designed to prevent injury and escape. Unfortunately, after managing tens of thousands of prisoners through an entire career, prison staff become guarded, defensive, and too frequently abusive. She doesn't acknowledge that the rules in a prison environment are in place because other prisoners have taken advantage of ambiguity, of inconsistencies, and of overlooked rules. Kerman tells her story in an intriguing way so you don't lose sight of the real happenings. It might be enough of a deterrent for students to think twice about some of their choices. Certainly many differences exist between the two, and the book is a far more thoughtful, considered, and rather well-written thing. The TV series is rather shinier, though it too contains dark and darkly humorous moments. For anyone interested in the experiences of jail and the life, both cold and heartless and joyful and heartwarming, Kerman's book is a must-read. Thank you for watching. Do not forget to subscribe and leave your comments below.